I'm the one who provide for you. I'm Jehovah Nissi. I'm a war man and I fight for you. Give him praise here, somebody. The fight is fixed because the battle is the Lord's. Somebody give him praise here. And so after he got the word from God, the Bible said in 2 Chronicles 20 there that Jehoshaphat consulted with the people and they got some singers. All they wanted to do is to just sing praises unto God. Is there any praise in this house today? You know something is facing you, but you know that praise can change the atmosphere. I said, yes, any praise in this house today? Yes, the battle is on. Come on, things are against you, but you can still praise God and say like the psalmist David, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He said, yeah, do I walk through the valley? Yes, Holy Ghost, some of you're only going through a valley. You're not stopping there. You're only passing through. Come on, somebody. I hear the songman says, yeah, do I walk through the valley of the shadow of death? I fear no evil. Say, neighbor, I'm not stopping, I'm passing through. I know Satan want me dead. He want my wife dead, want my husband dead, want my children dead. But I'm gonna live because I'm only walking through the valley of the shadow of death. Somebody go ahead and give God a praise. Say, neighbor, I'm only passing through. Come on, find somebody and say, hello, neighbor, I'm only passing through. It but for a moment, because here the psalmist in Psalm 130, weeping, hey, it's but for a night, but joy is coming in the morning. Somebody is about to rejoice again. Somebody, you lost your joy, but your joy is coming back again. Come on, give him a praise. You're weeping now because of what is coming against you, but the time is coming. You're gonna sing the wondrous story of the Christ who died for you. Shout glory.
The Lord told them where the enemies were. And they didn't have to use one sword.
Come on now. Come on.
All God wants us to do sometimes just to praise him.
Come on now.
My God.
It looked crazy. Facing an enemy. And all you do is praising God. Facing all your bills piling up. And all you can do is praise God. Husband walk out, gone, leave you. And all you can do is praise God. Somebody say, man, you're crazy. Husband gone, wife gone, children gone, and you're still praising God. I hear Brother Job say, though he slay me, yet will I trust him, because all my appointed time, I'm gonna wait until my change come. Tell somebody, say, just wait, man, just wait. My change is coming. Things are rough now. I'm coming up on the rough side of the mountain. Your mountain is rough right now, but you're doing your best to make it in. If you slip, get up and move on. If you slide, get up and move on. Because you're not gonna stop until you get to the top. Can somebody praise him? That song good a while ago. You're not gonna stop until you get to the top. Come on, somebody. As long as I have the Lord beside me, it is all right. As long as he watches over my soul, it is all right. I don't care what the enemies are saying. There is a God in Israel. I hear the psalmist says in Psalm 1. Come on, somebody. He said in Psalm 1, you shall be planted by the rivers of water. Bring forth your fruit in your season. Your leaves also shall not wither. And whatsoever you do it shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore, not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. Somebody stand on your feet and give God a praise. Wow. Say never set yourself. Think it's not yet, you just hold on. Tell you something's about to happen in this church. Somebody give God a praise. They went towards the enemy. Just singing. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. For his mercy endured forever. When you tell God that his mercy endure forever, God's, I've got to come down. I've got to move because somebody know how to praise me. God never told them to appoint singers. God never told Jehoshaphat to sing praises. But Jehoshaphat knew there's something about praise. Oh, come on, somebody. I said Jehoshaphat knew that there's something about praise. And if you know what praise can do, some of you, when they come and criticize you, don't have to answer them back. Just bust a praise. Hallelujah, somebody. You're not talking to me. When they come and want to put you down, think they're better off than you, say, honey, I am what I am. By the grace of God, in him I live, in him I move, in him I have. My Pete, is there any worship in this house? I say, is there any worshiper in this house? Are you facing a battle today? Is your back against the wall? God said the battle is not yours. But it's the Lord's. Because Jehoshaphat believed the word he heard, he could sing. The reason why some of you are not singing and praising God, you don't believe the report. You don't believe the report. Because if you believe what God said, you don't wait to see it. You praise him because you know it's already done. Oh God, come on, hear somebody. I say you praise him because you know it's already done. And now you're just waiting to see the result. So when the result comes, you're not surprised. Oh, come on, the church of God. Because already you praise him for the result. And now it manifests yourself. I'm not surprised because I praised him before. So I don't care what Satan had in mind. Praises can change. Oh, God, come on, Holy Ghost. Hear this. Praises can change circumstances. Praises can change atmosphere. Praises can change direction. It doesn't matter what where the enemy's going on it. Just begin to praise God and watch what God will do in your life. Because you know it's not your battle, it's God. And because you can't fight, if you fight, you can't win. If you fight, you know you can't win. So I just leave everything into his hands. And because I leave it in God's hand, I just let God work it out. Because sometimes to do some things that God to look foolish.
Yes.
Hundreds of thousands of people came against Jehoshaphat. And all he chose was some people to sing praise. Watch this. One praise that comes from God has a whole heap of missile going through it. So you missed that. One praise from God through the Spirit. When that thing leaves your mouth, it may come out like one. You may about scatter shot.
Come on now. M16.
The police have some gun. The soldiers have some gun. One
gunshot leave the gun. But when that hit the target, oh God Almighty, there are some other bullets or pellets inside that one thing, and it explode on the inside, honey. That's what one praise can do. Just bust a praise, and God just take it, and it just cut us. When things ain't going one way, as it start to go, it start to expand like this way and that way. So within a certain region, it cover one big area. Can you imagine when them hundreds of people are praise God, oh God Almighty? Can you imagine when they begin to praise God, how much shot of fire, oh God Almighty? And is there no friendly fire in the kingdom? When we have the right purpose, when we know who we are going after, can you say amen, somebody? And so we know that the enemies began to turn against them own selves. That's not your battle. Say, neighbor, you don't have to fight in this. Don't even defend yourself. Just praise God and watch God work for you. It looks stupid, but just praise Him. They lie on you, you say, hallelujah, what a savior. You mean I'm so important that somebody can call me name? Come on, man. So you don't use what you heard to get you down, because you know who you are already. You know you're more than a conqueror, because in Him you live, in Him you move, in Him you have your being. Somebody give Him a praise in this house. The battle is not yours, and you know the story. They kill off themselves, and all Joseph did and Judah is went to gather spoil. God is going to allow some things to happen, that those that come in against you, you're going to get what them have. Those that want you to lose your job, they're going to leave in you. Just sing and praise God. Even if they carry your name to the boss, don't worry yourself, because there's a bigger boss. Come on, somebody. I said there's a bigger boss. If you doubt me, ask Mordecai. Come on, somebody. Oh, God, talk to me. When Achan, when what his name was? Haman, thank you, minister. Haman thought he was getting by with Mordecai. And because the king promoted him, he thought everybody should bow to him. And so Mordecai refused to bow. And he took Mordecai into the king. And he said, there's a set of people that don't regard our law. I want you to give me authority to wipe them out. And the king assured us gave him authority. And he got a letter signed and sealed and was distributed in all the province of the king. Amen. And when the Jews got those words, they became afraid. But somebody said, time is longer than rope. Come on, somebody. You may be getting some threatening from the enemy, honey. That's not the end of it. The battle is still going on. The fight is still on. It's only round two we are at. Come on and give God a praise. You may be getting punched, uppercut, lower cup, all below the belly, but you're still hanging on in there, because it's like this song, man. I'm gonna fight until I die, but I never run away. I'm on the battlefield for my Lord. Is there a praiser here today? And so, hey man, he got letter, and amen. When Mordecai heard, he went to where Esther was, and he said, news said, look, we need your help. Esther said, look, Mordecai, I'm not being called to see the king 30 days now. Without permission, you can't go into see him. Mordecai sent back words to tell her. Said, you think because you're in the palace, you are safe? Who to tell that God set you such a place for such a time as this? And then she sent back words saying, go tell Mordecai, fast 3 days, 3 nights, eat no bread, drink no water. At the end of 3 days and 3 nights, I am going in to see the king, because it's not my battle. I can't do it by myself, but my helper is in the
the Lord. Can somebody praise God? At the end of 3 days and 3 night fasting, my God, Esther went in and to see the king. Ordinary, if you go without permission, you are killed. But when you know it's not your battle, no man can kill you before your time. Come on, say neighbor, you can't kill me before my time. Come on, tell somebody, tell your neighbor, say neighbor, you can't touch me unless God give you permission. Come on, nobody can touch Pastor DC unless God give permission. Because in him I live, in him I move, in him I have my being. I wrap up, I tie up, and me tangle up. You can't say this, neighbor, you can't touch this. You can't touch this because I'm bought with a price. My life is hid with Christ in God. In him I live, in him I move, in him I have my being. If Satan could kill me, I would dead long time. Come here, lady. I said if Satan could kill, come here. I would dead long time. Come on. I'm not try, Satan, not try. You should not even be alive right now. But because of God's goodness and God's mercy, why you are here? Many traps were set for you, but God Almighty move on your behalf. So when they see you praise God, tell them to leave you alone. You got a right to praise him. Somebody help me and give God a praise. And God is gonna bless you. God is gonna anoint you. Shakam that I'm gonna sick and that I'm. Yes, 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 yes. In the name of Jesus. Fire! Fire! Hobo shake and that I'm. Fire, receive the fire. Woman, you're not leaving, you're the same way you came in. You're living different. God see your tears. God see, oh God, 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 God. So much tears. You're one of you survivor, but God brought you this far. Got a right to pray, oh God. Somebody help me and give God a praise. I said give God a praise. Give God a praise in this house. Haman thought he would get rid of Mordecai. Let me preach Bible. There are some folks want to get rid of some of us. Them don't like us because God bless you. But I'm gonna live. I shall live and not die. I'm gonna make an announcement. Not even death can take me out until my time comes. You know, hear me, somebody. I don't care what Satan plan. No gunman can't kill me. No rapist can't rape me. Because I'm his. I'm his forevermore. I don't belong to myself. I belong to him. Shout yes! Somebody want to wipe you out, but don't worry yourself. There is a God in Israel. Say neighbor. Some of you too lazy to talk to your neighbor. Say neighbor. There is a God in Israel. Circle yourself. Say circle neighbor. Circle. God is working on your behalf. Whether you know it or not, he's working on your behalf. Shout glory. Hallelujah! Somebody help me bless God, no man. Stand to your feet and take some praise break. Take a praise break. Take a praise break. Take a praise break. Take a praise break. Come on and give God some praise in this house. Because Jericho walls, yes, Holy Ghost. I said Jericho walls are coming down. I said Jericho wall is coming down for somebody. You wall up for too long. It's time it come down. It's time it come down. You want a breakthrough. It seems like everywhere you turn, every door locked. But in the name of Jesus, we break down every barrier. We tread upon serpents, upon scorpions, upon principalities, upon powers, in the name of Jesus. Somebody give God a hallelujah shout. Sit down, church. Watch this. So Esther had the wisdom prepare a feast. And sent. When she went to the king, first of all, the king stretched out the scepter. Mean that she's forgiven. What do you want, Esther? I'm inviting you and Haman to a banquet. Come on, talk to me, church. Hallelujah. When you know your enemies fighting against you, invite them for dinner. Because the Bible says if you're hungry, if your enemy hunger, feed him. Say you about feed your enemy. If you know your enemy, buy them T-bone steak. Now buy them no Bruce's patty or Tasty patty. Now buy them go to another little cheap restaurant. Get them to a big hotel and just treat them. Let them see how God is taking care of you. Although they want you bankrupt and dead, but let them know there's a I am. That I am. That is alive on me inside. If you can't shoot God, you can't shoot me, because I'm surrounded by his boundless love. I have protection from the Lord above. Angels walk beside me. When I leave my house, angels live with me. When I come to church, angels join the other angels that in this house. Can you imagine? Deacon bring angel, minister bring angel, deacon bring angel, you bring angel, I'm my angel, Lord Jesus. Can you imagine how much angel with the choir right now? Enough angel in this place here. Come on, somebody. So we are well armed and dangerous. Say neighbor, find a neighbor. Say neighbor, I'm armed and I'm dangerous, because the Lord is on my side. If God be for us, then who can be against us? If God will fight my battle, who can come against me and win? No weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. Every tongue that shall rub a shake and rub a sit, that shall be under rubber, shall rise against me. In judgment shall be condemned. I don't know where here man is. Here man can't stay where he's at. Here man can't touch me. Let here man do all the planning. So here man plan. I saw God wipe out. Sing with me. Sing this out with me. I saw here man plan. I saw God wipe out. I saw here man plan. I saw God wipe out. I don't care what Haman is doing. Haman can't stop me right now. Haman plan. But God wipe out. Anybody want to buy $10 for this tape? $10. Sit down. Science! Science! Haman plan. But God wipe out. Haman plan. But God wipe out. Haman planning, he planning hard. Planning to wipe me well out. Haman plan. But God wipe out. Haman plan. But God wipe out. Sigma. Haman plan. But God wipe out. Haman planning to kill me. Same plan us, so God wipe out. Haman plan. But God wipe out. Sit down. Let me prove. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Haman! Shakorabosi was planning to wipe out the Jews. But so Haman planned. So God wipe out. So Haman thought the queen invited him to banquet. It felt good. I am special, Lord God. So after him ate and him belly full, him went home and said, bash it to his wife, whatever the wife name, I don't remember. Said, guess what, honey? I was invited to eat with the queen. Then the wife said, no, go to the king and be like girls and kill him, man.
Kill Mordecai.
To kill Mordecai, rather. His wife named Zeres, yes. Zeres, watch the Zeres is.
Yes, come on, son. Thank you again.
Zeres gave him information. Yes, Lord. Not because people are treat you good, means you must wipe them out and take others against him and all of that. No. She thought he was at such a strategic point where he have no power. Because up to then, he did not know that Esther Hadassah was a Jew. And if it touch one Jew, it touch all Jews. And so he felt good. He went home. And the wife, can you imagine how Mrs. Zeres, honey, that banquet with the queen, asked the king for Mordecai. Be careful, a wrong influence. Be careful what people tell you about your brethren and your bite without checking it out carefully. And because Haman had already sent off a letter for the Jews to wipe out, he felt comfortable. So Esther decided to prepare one more banquet. Let somebody say one more time.
One more time.
Say, never just go one more time. Oh God. No, give up, man. Don't give up. Just go one more time. Let somebody say, try again. Don't quit. No retreat. No surrender. Try one more time. Hallelujah. So she went in to see the king. The king said, what is it, Esther? Up to half of my kingdom will I give you. Said, if it please the king, let the king and Haman come to a banquet. Then Haman was on his way over. Because Zeres said, get permission to kill him. So he built a gallows, saying, Mordecai must dead. This Jew must dead. And in the month of March, Adar, the month Adar was the 18th of March, where all the Jews should be wiped out. And so, when it was going in that night, God said to the king, it's not in the Bible, you won't see that. No sleep for you tonight. No wine either. Call for the book of the Chronicles and begin to turn page. I want to show you something. Satan plan. I want to see man. Satan, oh God Almighty. And so, and as he turned the page, the Holy Ghost says, stop right there. I'm using my spiritual antenna, okay? So you got to follow me. And he saw where Mordecai spared his life. And he called one of the chamberlain and said, what was done? No, this is unusual. But when God is fighting a battle, when God is coming through for you, God Almighty, just as how God allowed a position to be made for Joseph in Egypt where there was no governor before, but God created a position. Because, oh God, come on to somebody. It's not that there was a governor. There was no governor in Egypt. But when God decided to bless you, he can create position where there is none. Somebody give God a praise here today. It's not a custom for him to ask, why did he stop at that point? Because he was divinely set up by God. He asks, was there any gift thing given to him? The chamberlain says, no. And he said, who is in the courts? Haman. He said, Haman was on his way to ask permission and to go to the banquet to kill the king, to kill Mordecai. And one of the chamberlain says, Haman. The king said, call him in. Yeah. No, I don't feel good.
Don't feel too good when people call you at times.
Tell them again.
You don't know them reason.